You know, I'm thinking about this flu shot, and I feel for these ladies, Alonda Watson, Megan Duncan, and Denise Mercurius. They're the names, and you know, I get it. They don't want to take the flu shot. They don't want to be forced to do it. They said, we're just sitting in a cubicle crunching numbers. So why is it that you could be forced by your company to take a flu shot, and if you don't do it, lose your job? And the solution from the company to wear a mask seems ridiculous because, let's face it, the mask is only going to prevent certain things. If you sneeze or cough, and you ought to be paying attention to that anyway, sneezing into your elbow, you know, in the crook of your arm, like, you know, pay attention. Kira wipes down the console every day when she comes in here. I see the Lysol's out. Look, there's a way to keep yourself from getting sick. But I'm not a doctor. So I wanted to talk with Dr. Charles Simone. He was an attending physician to former presidents. So, Doc Simone, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for taking the time. I know you're down in Washington, and you're attending to all sorts of medical business. But I have to ask you, doctor, there's an issue in New Jersey where this company, the Lutheran Social Ministries of New Jersey, is potentially now going to fire three workers today because they won't take the flu shot. So my question to you is, where do you stand on the flu shot? And then where do you stand on mandatory flu shots? What am I missing on this issue?
The problem is this. There are 200 viruses that we know about that cause the flu. And at best, flu vaccines might be effective against only influenza A and B, which represents about 10% of all these viruses. Now, when you look at the information, looking at the Cochrane Collaboration data and the Lancet Infectious Diseases, a journal highly respected and a group of people highly respected to review all kinds of information, they say that the flu vaccine is not effective in babies, involving 51 studies with 294,000 children ages 6 to 24 months. This not effective in adults, involving 48 reports with 66,000 adults in it. Vaccinations are reduced only the risk of influenza by 6% or by less than one day, which is 0.16 days.
So what do you mean? What do you mean less than one day, Doc? What does that mean? It delays it a day?
Yeah, that's it. Delay of the virus by only less than one day, 0.1 of a day.
So why is it that some companies now are saying you are forced to do it? I mean, look, this would not be the first time that one person jumps off the bridge and everybody follows. You know,
no, okay, of course,
right?
Of
I mean, but why data, why is it? What data are they using?
The data are clear also for the elderly. 5,700 studies, no evidence at all for protection. So why is this happening? What happens is, you know, the CDC and the FDA are governmental agencies that employ scientists, but are led by politically appointed people who ultimately approve medicines and policies. Scientists should guide our science policies and not politically appointed people. The weakest among us, the very young, the very old, need the most protection, and they're the ones that have the least protection by the flu vaccine. So these are policies set by lay people, not by scientists, not by physicians, but by lay people who are politically appointed. And then everyone follows the emperor's clothes story.
Now, let me ask you this. In terms of the number of deaths, I was reading that there will be 30,000 people who will die of the flu this year. That's just projected.
The usual number is anywhere from 40 to 60,000 people die every year of the flu in this country. Every year.
Now, how do you prevent that? I just want to ask you, before you answer that, I have said this before. I've said it. I've said it on this show. I've said it on our other show, Chasing News. That this idea that we're doing anything to prevent the virus because it is not. It's based on essentially a guess of what will be the prominent strain that year. So they develop it from whatever the strain was the previous year. Is that accurate?
Well, that's even worse than that. Remember, 200 viruses and only A and B, influenza A and B, have vaccines against it, which represents less than 10%. But here's the important piece of information. Every 14 to 21 days, the flu virus mutates. So even if you had a vaccine that was made last week with last week's flu,
right,
this week's flu is totally different.
So what do you recommend people do? As a medical doctor, what do you recommend people do?
We have a 10-point plan for people, and what we have to do is show them how to frequently decontaminate their hands and face and sinus areas. Use hydrogen peroxide gargle routinely twice a day, proper hydration, a good multiple vitamin formulation, zinc 50 milligrams once every week. That's been shown to decrease the morbidity and mortality of children and adults. 50 milligrams of zinc every week, once a week, during the high flu vaccine.
All right, now, Doc, hold on. I'm writing this down now. I need to take 50 mil. Now, is that, it comes in a pill, right? You take a vitamin. Yeah. You can go buy it.
Yeah, very inexpensive.
All right, so 50 milligrams of zinc. What else do I need to do? Wash my hands frequently?
Wash your hands frequently, but also wash your face and your nose, because this is where the viruses come from, right?
Right.
So if you wash your hands and not your face and nose, then you're still in trouble. Hydrogen peroxide right out of the bottle. Put a little bit in a cup, swig it, gargle with it, and throw it out. You know, it's a great, inexpensive formula to do, too. Quercetin. Quercetin is a analog of vitamin C. You can take quercetin 500 milligrams twice a day, and that'll help a great deal to decrease it. Quercetin prevents viruses from docking onto the cell. Quercetin is the prototype of the antiviral agent that they use prescription-wise.
All right, Doc. You know what? I've got to take a break for traffic and weather, but Dr. Charles Simone, former attending physician to President Ronald Reagan, I always appreciate your perspective, even though you and I don't see eye to eye on bacon. That's okay. I'm with you on this flu shot thing. I think it's ridiculous. We are talking. It's anecdotal. It is political. It's driven by money, and it's not helping anybody. And now you're talking about people getting caught in the crosshairs that may lose their jobs. All right, Doc, you have a great weekend. Get back from D.C. safe, and we'll be talking very soon, I'm sure.